So I know I've done this video before, but I think it needs repeating periodically. When I see shit like, all of these YouTube ads with Joe Rogan's voice, dude, bro, billion-dollar industries are terrified. I mean, all this just ridiculous shit. You know what I mean? I understand that's not Joe Rogan, that that's an AI-generated voice of Joe Rogan, but he definitely is getting paid for letting them use his voice. Okay. I've heard shit come out of his mouth that explained very clearly to me his actual level of understanding of the universe, life, reality, the sciences. I have heard things come out of his mouth that told me beyond a shadow of a doubt. Okay, so this is the limit of his education, and after that, he's out of his depth. Okay. I liked it when he stuck to his pavement, which is basically doing MMA, because he himself understands the martial arts. He's a martial artist himself. And so when he stays in that lane, I got ultimate respect for the man. Okay. But when he starts talking about the sciences in a way where everything is a question, everything is a fucking question, okay? I'm sorry. Your stock goes down. The saying, mother, father, whichever you choose to use, but necessity is the mother of invention. And that's how people kind of look at technological growth. But I can tell you that there's nothing further from the truth that necessity is the mother of invention. I've proved it over and over and over again with a modern device. Okay? So I'm a taxophilite. Not only am I a taxophilite, I'm a Sagittarius. So when it comes to the bow, it's something that I've been shooting my whole life. And I remember getting my first compound bow, non-recurve compound, then my first recurve compound. When they first came out, I was all over it because I was always a really, really good shot, but I was always a little skinny kid. Even though I was strong, it would be nice to have all of that pressure taken off. And about, I don't know, I guess about 3 years into this whole revolution with cams, the bow sight came into the fore. Now, the bow sight is very, it's a very simple device, okay? For the best way is to have an arrow rest so that it's leaving the bow exactly the same way every single time. And then you have a hole that is placed within the strands of the string. And that hole, we're going to call it a hole because that's what it is. That hole has a little attachment to it with a rubber that goes to the riser. So that when you pull your string back, this tail on the hole aligns itself fairly straight with the riser. Okay? So now you have a hole in your string. Then on the front of the bow, you have distance pins that tell you if your arrow is sitting on the rest and you're looking through the hole down your arrow at the pin, theoretically, if you fire enough arrows, you'll have distances on your scale that are fairly accurate. And I mean really accurate within 30 yards. Okay? But if necessity was the mother of invention, then why was it that for thousands of years, the primary technology for war and survival, the bow and arrow, okay? People, it was the law you had to practice because they were, heavy stave type oak, you know, heavy fucking bows. It took a lot to pull them back, okay? But even like the Chinese technologies, their recurves, and the Mongolians and people that had refined the bow even better because they lived in this open plain area. Nobody thought to put a fucking hole in the string. Now, why the fuck, after 2,000 years, did no one think to put a fucking hole in the string? Now, okay, they don't have plastics now, because the ones I've seen are made of either brass or plastic, okay? But they had bone. They had dried sinew. They had facsimiles where they could have put a hole in the bowstring. Because with that, everybody's a good shot. I can take someone who's never shot a bow before, take them to the range, show them how the bow sight works, and have them dropping arrows, you know, into a target one after another. Anyone can do it. Doesn't take anything special, especially if you're using a release, okay? But for 2,000 years, no one thought to put a fucking hole in the string. So don't tell me about necessity and the mother of invention, okay? Because anyone who's fired a bow understands that when you pull that back, when you pull this string back to your eye, it's no longer a thin string, okay? It's this big, wide, white, blurry line. That's what it is, okay? It's not precise in any way, shape, or form. You could be off 2 or 3 feet either way at 20 yards, okay? No problem, because the string turns into this big, wide obstacle in front of your eye. Whereas when you put a hole right there, when you pull it back and there's a hole right there, you can see right through your string, everything becomes clear. You understand that you are centered and that now you just need to get your elevation pin correct. 2,000 years. Think about that. When it was necessary, whereas like if you could shoot a bow like I can with a sight, I'd be like the world's greatest bowman 1,000 years ago with modern technology. People would just be fucking blown away. They would think that, I mean, they wouldn't know what to think. If you had a modern compound curved bow with a bow sight and all that, but let me tell you something, okay? Without a doubt, it wouldn't take long before they were copying your technology. It may not be made of the same high-tech material, but they'd be finding a fucking way to make it work, okay? Because that's just how people are. Why did no one put a hole in the string? So that whole idea about necessity is out the fucking window, because that's how you protected yourself. That's how you fed yourself. I mean, that's how people went to war. And you're telling me that anyone and everyone could be an archery fucking bullseye artist with the correct sights set up, and no one thought about doing it. I've never even seen ancient bows that at museums. I've never seen one with elevation pins, not even elevation pins. And you think that an elevation pin would be the very first thing, because, well, instinct shooters, which is how I kind of grew up being an instinct shooter with our 35-pound fiberglass bows. That's what we had back then. That was the cheap, affordable unit for kids, 35 cents an arrow. Yeah, instinct shooting is one thing, but for taking someone who's not really good with a bow and making them an outstanding, excellent shot just takes two little pieces of technology, a fucking stick and a hole in the string. A stick, just fucking cowhide glue, whatever, on whatever, bison, whatever, fucking animal glue, a stick to your riser, and now you know exactly how far that arrow's going to go. Yeah, nobody thought of it. If anyone can ever explain that to me, why for 2,000 years nobody thought to put a fucking hole in a string, I would really like to hear your theory. Okay. I really would. I am very interested in that subject because I've thought about it for so long. It's the very day, because I thought I was pretty fucking good. The day I put a bow sight on my bow, a complete system, and used a release, I realized just how good I wasn't before. Okay. Incredibly accurate. 5 arrows into this gopher hole that was 20 yards away, and I was just like, oh, fuck. This is it. That was it. I mean, this whole rush came over me because I understood at that moment that anybody could be fucking great. And then I started thinking, well, wait a minute. It was the most important technological advance in human history, the bow and arrow, and fucking nobody thought to put a hole in the string.